Turns out, I'm in the thriving district of Matunga, famous for the South Indian Hindu temples and Southern Indian immigrants. But the further in I go, the more nervous I get.
Right, Captain Madras. Rasmadil, no chicken anywhere.
I'm meeting Rashmi Uday Singh. She's India's top food critic and wrote the country's very first restaurant guide.
Rashmi.
Hey.
How are you, my darling?
Great to see you.
Nice to see you.
Thank you. Lovely to see you.
You look wonderful.
Thank you. And you look really wonderful, but you look a little hungry.
Do you know what? I'm very hungry. All I want is butter chicken.
This is a pure vegetarian restaurant. The district is pure vegetarian. Even if you want to rent an apartment, Gordon,
right,
you can't if you're a non-vegetarian.
Serious?
Thrown out.
I know there's a lot of veggies in India, but a whole town, they're convinced vegetarianism can combat the evils of modern life.
What is it with meat eaters? Why are you so anti it?
Eating so much of chunks of meat and foie gras and all that, we believe that that is what is responsible for your bad temper.
Eating meat made you bad tempered? What a load of bollocks.
Unlike all that stuff you eat, this is actually good for your spirit, your emotions, your feelings. It will give you calm. It will relax you.
Meat doesn't make me angry. It makes me excited.
Just calm down. Let's get you something to eat.
Please.
Then we'll talk about our South Indian mission.
Yeah, let's.
Okay.
Chicken!
Repeat after me. Promise.
Promise.
To try. The vegetarian food.
Seriously, I promise I will try vegetarian food.
With an open mind.
With an open mind.
Okay.
To show me what's out there, Rashmi's ordered me the most popular veggie meal in India, idli sambar and rolled dosa pancake.
What's that, a lampshade?
Isn't that beautiful?
Where's the light bulb? We buy things like that at the flea market in London.
You have a closed,
what is that?
Funny mind.
First, I'm eating the idlis in a spicy sambar soup.
The texture's like a warm scone. It's nice. Yeah, I like that. It's Moorish. It's lovely.
Okay, lovely.
Nice.
You have an open mind and you enjoyed it.
Definitely.
Against my better judgment, I've asked Rashmi's advice on where to find great vegetarian food. She has a radical suggestion.
You are going to visit an ashram.
A what?
An ashram.
An ashram.
A spiritual retreat. You're going to go and live there.
With monks?
There's a lot of fabulous vegetarian food there.
I'm not spending all week and my last sort of exciting week as a vegetarian, no chance.
Okay,
I'm going now.
No.
The whole week.
No. I'm going to go back with a journey, not just to India, but into yourself.
I am not fucking Amy Winehouse's husband.
Young man.
I'm not checking into rehab.
You're not checking into rehab. You're going to find yourself. You are in our country. You are our guest. You are like God. The God in me salutes the God in you. Have a great time. Good Lord be with you.
The Lord, Jesus.
And call me if you need me.
Yes, absolute
yes,
definite.
Yes.
Jesus, taxi! I was a little bit scared to say no to her. So I just took it, shut the fuck up here, listen to what she's got to say, eat your dosa, do you know what I mean? And get out of there alive before she sort of, you know. More fitting place to come back and have my final dinner in this unique building. Can't wait to meet the chef. I know he lost several members of his team throughout those terrorist attacks, and yeah, quite nervous really. I just want to put my head down and graft. Thank you.
Herman Oberoi, executive chef of the Taj, is India's most influential chef. He's cooked for everyone, from Prince Charles to Bill Clinton. There are 25 high society guests coming tonight, and for Chef Oberoi, everything has to be perfect.
You should be giving only the best. If you're a good chef, you should be giving the best.
Oh, this is very, very good. It's very typical of Kerala, and I think it's fabulous.
Batter fry, very British. I like that. I've got the British in me, so that I loved it.
Very subtle, but it's certainly present, the South Indian flavour.
I like what I'm eating. Whatever it is, it is wonderful.
I'm old and deaf, speak up.
I thought that for a footballer, he cooks beautifully.
I think it's a good effort.
But is my culinary mentor Rashmi impressed?
What is amazing is that he's managed to distill the flavors of South India and yet put in his own typical Gordon Ramsay's twist.
Wow, what a beautiful room. Excellent. Good to see you. First of all, thank you so much for coming. I couldn't think of a more fitting place to confirm how exquisite your cuisine is. So a big thank you to Chef. The team has been amazing. Congratulations, a phenomenal hotel, and it's back as number one.
Thank
Brilliant.
You.
The time's come for me to say goodbye to a country I've fallen in love with.
Being here for this length of time has really helped to not just renew my passion with Indian food, but it's made me think more, because it has an amazing effect.